What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Realtors React, where Ryan and I react to buying Beverly Hills. I'm excited about this one because I've actually never
seen an episode,
No. But I've heard it's one of the most realist reality TV shows out there. Look at that view.
It's a great way to get the word out about the property. It's like, who's gonna find the buyer first? All the agents are trying to get their connection, get the phone number, get to the assistant. Everybody wants to be the one to make that sale. Oh, it's fair game.
So one thing I love about this already is that they're talking about the value of broker preview, literally episode one, season one, and they're going right into it. How valuable is broker preview?
It's very valuable. It gets the word out. You get all the agents together to showcase the brand new listing. That's where you make connections. That's where you potentially could find the buyer with an agent that comes to that, that maybe brings it back to their client. So it's huge. Yep. That's what you need to do.
Insane.
Kind of our reaction every time we walk into a $30 million property, right?
Like, it's probably more than 30 million, but yeah.
30 million plus.
Yeah.
And some billionaire will buy it, and it will be their fifth home. It's funny when in broker preview, when they're like, do you have a buyer for it? And it's like, well, I'm not thinking about anybody off the top of my head, but I might have a buyer for it. That's what Mauricio is doing right now.
He might have some for it, but this is, it's got to have a nice little spread too. They got a bartender and the wine going. And
That's a big deal. When I go to broker preview, I love it when the agent takes the time to put out a spread, to make it kind of like an event, make it a party, because the agents want to congregate around the food. They want to chat about the property. They want to learn more about it. They want to talk about it. So it's like, they're doing it right.
Yeah.
They're doing it right.
Picked up and carried here from
it's
Europe.
Insane. It's really well done.
I love my job so much. This is insane.
The business is about relationships. It's about connections. And just because you're a newer agent doesn't mean that you may not have amazing connections through your family, through your friends, and you might realize, oh, I know someone that might be looking for something like this. So there's definitely a competition.
Yeah, I agree. I agree 100%. I mean, this is a relationship business. The more we spend time with the people that we're working with, the more we understand their needs, the more properties we see, the better matchmaking we can do. And that's what it sounds like they're doing right here.
Yeah, and he's got the whole team there, which I love too. He brought all of his agents with him, and they're all kind of getting a feel for it, checking out the inventory in the market, and then, hey, maybe they have somebody off the top of their head that might be looking for this that they're working with, and that's the idea.
Yep. Yep, the field outing is the team outing is definitely a good move.
I mean, we do various things with the team, and we do events with the teams here and there. We try to get as many of the agents together with us to go out to broker preview as well. We go to training events together as well, continuing education and the business. We take the team for that. So we do fun things too, Disneyland.
Yeah, I mean,
lunches, dinners.
For us, it's, you know, Ryan and I were out there, and so being able to bring the members on the team with us, rather than us telling them what we do and rather than them asking us what we do, we're showing them what we do. And that's the best way to learn and the best way to create camaraderie on the team and culture is to do things together.
Oh yeah.
And that's what I love about these guys right here too. They're doing it together.
Like every time.
You think someone who has $65 million is going to One Oak?
Ben in general is an idiot.
And here comes the drama.
Hey, we know Ben. I don't know if he's an idiot, but I'm down to laugh at it. Yeah. I think this guy, I never met this guy Joey, but he seems like a funny guy.
I started in this business. I don't have nearly the volume Ben does, but I will have a buyer for this house before Ben Belak.
Wow.
And that's simply because I have much more of...
It's very competitive sounding. Like broker preview for us in OC, like everybody just takes a look, chit chats. Maybe you have somebody, you talk business a little bit, but this seems very competitive. Like they want to find the buyer before the other person.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of ego involved. It's a cutthroat industry. Yeah. These price points, the commission payout on $65 million is so astronomical that the average person can't even comprehend what that number even looks like. And these people do it monthly.
Yeah. Ooh, that's nice. Little modern farmhouse going on with a lot going
on
inside.
There's a lot
of plants.
A lot of plants in that place.
Real or fake, there's a lot.
So this person just lives like this. You can tell when a home is staged and when it's not. There's probably some design in this, but this person lives here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know too many of the other cast members. No. I know Ben and I know John and then obviously Mauricio because he's the head of it all. Mm-hmm. $6.2 million.
Wow.
Clean.
Nice. Modern, sleek touch.
Very white.
Yeah.
Very bright, lots of glass.
See, I like that, but it's just not conducive to a family. I have twins.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, easy, LA man. Super realtor over here rolling in, screeching.
Yes.
Come on, Ben, show it to us.
My insane new listing on Bel Air Road.
Oh, is this? Yeah. Are we gonna see some drama?
We might. I mean, that's what these shows,
I love it,
base themselves on. The drama is what sells.
Yeah. That's what I love about, I haven't watched, but from what I hear, there's a lot of drama, but it's a very realistic real estate show.
Well, Christy says all the time, of all the shows she's ever watched, reality TV-wise, this is the realest one out there. So I'm sure Netflix is stirring up the pot a little bit to sell viewerships.
Oh yeah.
But you know, we know Ben and we know John and we know what they actually do, and they do this kind of stuff. So a lot of this stuff here is pretty legit.
1.35 million views.
Benjamin.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you for having me.
This is Costas. So yo, I'm glad you came up. You know, I wanted you to see the importance of making content. And you know, I started creating content because I wanted to be known when someone searches for Beverly Hills
Super Realtor.
That too.
Ben Bullock's videos are incredibly cheesy.
This guy just sounds bashing. I love
Beverly
it.
Beverly Hills Super Realtor.
They're the corniest things that I've ever seen put on the internet.
Let me just get on my studious mid-century modern glasses.
And especially when you're getting...
There may be some corniness to his videos, but I'll tell you this, and I say this all the time, at least he's doing video, right? It's very easy to sit back and go, videos are corny, or oh, their videos are this or that.
Here's the thing about it. If people are talking about it, then that's what you want.
Exactly.
Whether it's good or bad.
And you know, Beverly Hills Super Realtor, like, is he a superhero? But hey, Ben, it
works. Any publicity is good publicity in this business, huh?
I agree. Yeah. At least he's doing the video. Yeah. And he's doing it consistently, and that's what it takes.
Yeah.
Gosh, creating content for us? I mean, you know, we're still working on ways to expand our brand. We're still working on ways to expand our network and sell more homes through the content that we create. Mm-hmm. It's not easy, but I will say that it is putting us on the map. And a lot of people watch, and even though they don't comment and maybe they don't reach out to us, they watch, and that's a great start. Mm-hmm. I've actually seen this episode. I'm watching it in Australia.
Are you Erin?
Yes.
Erin, it's a pleasure to meet you. I'm Alexia.
And this is Shayna.
Hi, nice to meet you. Don't mind my dog, sorry.
So I guess we'll, you know, make our way to the heart of the home, the kitchen. Shayna's an amazing chef, so she's always in the kitchen. So she chose some stone and marble that's just like...
Is that the owner?
Is that the owner sitting there? Seller?
It's quartzite?
Anyway, rough.
I hate that she's sitting right behind me right now, listening to me. It's not that I don't know, it's that I just... I'm flustered.
Look, to her defense, whether she completely fucks this up or not,
the owner
the owner being there is gonna throw everybody off.
Yeah, yeah,
everybody. It's tough.
You're hypercritical around how you talk about the owner's property, and they have emotional connections to it, so it's very, very stressful. We never want the owner of the home we're selling in the property anytime we're showing a buyer. That's real estate 101. But real estate 102, you gotta know your product inside and out. Mm-hmm. You really do.
You know, one thing that's important to take note of in the price is that the furniture is not included.
What is the price per square footage?
The price per square foot is $1,118.
Okay.
Should we move on?
Yeah.
Dang, she dodged a bullet.
So obviously give you a little moment to focus on the fireplace, because I think that marble.
Why would she, the owner, sit there? It's like the weirdest thing ever. Go to the coffee shop.
Onyx stone, it's like a type of crystal.
Your daughter just turned 1 year old.
Yeah.
Oh my lord.
Congratulations.
Yeah, that's real estate no-no. Owner can't be there.
If I was the person showing, I would, number one, make sure that I knew as much as possible about the property. Number two, I would request not to have the seller present.
Yep, the seller wouldn't be there. Just wouldn't be there. Like, I don't care how stubborn the seller was, I would help them understand at the deepest level that them being there would negatively affect our bottom line, and they hired us to get their home sold for the highest and best price. And if they want us to do that, then they have to follow the rules our way. Like, at some point we have to lead our clients, right? Like, it's their home, but if they don't take our advice, why are we there?
And then obviously coach up your teammate a little bit.
You know, absolutely.
It happens, by the way. It happens, but you know.
It is.
It's a learning, it's a teachable moment. Sometimes. Yeah, they've discussed it, or they've been there, or said, oh, I'll just hang out while you do the showing. I won't be in your way. But what I always say, and this is the rule, it's like the buyer and the other agent are gonna feel somewhat uncomfortable if they see that you're there. They can't feel free to take it in and maybe talk and ask questions and value and say their opinion when the seller's there.
Thank you guys again for following along on Realtors React, where Ryan and I talked today about buying Beverly Hills. If we're talking about reality TV shows, there's a ton of them out there when it comes to real estate, but it does seem like buying Beverly Hills is the realest reality TV show. And I think I'm a little bit biased, and we're a little bit biased, because we have friends on the show. So we recommend it. You should check it out.